They're trying to silence us on speaking out against them.
Well, first at 6, parents in Hendricks County are raising concerns about a local school district's policy that takes aim at what parents say on social media.
The Northwest Hendricks School Corporation is standing behind its parent code of conduct tonight, but the ACLU is calling it a violation of the First Amendment.
Call 6 Investigates' Kara Kenny has been digging into what's in the policy and whether it's actually enforceable.
Tiffany Matthews has been a vocal critic of the Northwest Hendricks School Corporation, both on social media and at school board meetings.
I don't feel safe sending my kids to school with anybody anymore because I don't trust anybody in this school system.
The district has faced sharp criticism for keeping Tyler Bruce on staff, a teacher and coach accused of sexual misconduct with a student. He's under criminal investigation, but hasn't been charged and denies the allegations.
And I have personally posted about Tyler Bruce.
Tiffany says at the December board meeting, the district handed out copies of the parents' code of conduct, which was enacted in 2016. It says parents should not use social media to make rude or offensive comments towards staff members or the school. It also says parents should not use social media to campaign against or fuel outrage against staff members, the school, or policies implemented by the school or district.
And they're trying to silence us on speaking out against them and the way that they've handled the whole situation.
According to the policy, parents who violate the code of conduct can be removed from school property and even banned from school grounds in the future. Call 6 Investigate shared a copy with the ACLU of Indiana.
I think this is flagrantly unconstitutional. The overarching problem is that you have the government saying, if we don't like what you're saying, we can punish you. And the government's not allowed to do that. That's why we have the First Amendment.
Legal Director Ken Falk says the policy sends a bad message to students who are learning about the Constitution.
If a parent contacts us today and say this policy's in effect and I feel constrained in what I can say on social media, they've been damaged. We could file a lawsuit against the school.
Corporation spokeswoman tells us the district has no authority nor desire to police social media beyond its own. Comments on corporation media considered abusive, profane, intimidating, rude, or offensive will be deleted and the poster potentially blocked from further comment. Parents are discouraged from taking their concerns to social media because that practice is generally unproductive and usually leads to rumor and misinformation. The statement goes on to say parents should instead take their concerns directly to a staff member or administrator.
We're trying to get things done. You know, they're not doing it, so we've got to find a way to get it done, and social media is the way to get the word out there that, hey, this isn't being handled properly.
In Hendricks County, Kara Kenny, RTV6.
Well, the district says it can enforce consequences if someone is exhibiting threatening or disruptive behavior while on school property. This can include removal from school property and banning the parents from school grounds.